speaking. I work in media. I work in legislation. And Stacey is my uncle. My father was his oldest brother, Mike Gardner. And Stacey took it upon himself to give me that encouragement. That's the one word I've heard all day today about him, is he encouraged people. And before I would go and sit at that table with those legislators and fight for my people, it was Stacey that gave me the fire and the encouragement. And so today is really hard because he wasn't here to give me that encouragement to come speak at his service. So this morning I woke up, I spilled everything on me on the way here. Just an absolute mess. And Odie asked me to speak because he said I would be the one for the nieces and the nephews to not break down because I do this all the time. But I've never spoken at a funeral, and I never thought in a million years Stacey would be the one I would do the first one. Before I get into this, I would love for the other nieces and nephews just to come up here. You don't have to say anything if you don't want, but just come up before I get started. No pressure. Pressure Michael, Drika. I see y'all. Just come on up. Wes. Shared this story with family members. I just shared it with my mother last night for the first time, is that Stacey was my healer and he saved my life. And only he and I know the truth of what was going on with me. My father, Mike Gardner, was murdered when I was 9 years old. Stacey's about 6 years older than me. And I never recovered. I was lost. I was one of those lost people. And I disconnected from my family and my aunts and my uncles. Each one of them means so much to me, and I don't express it, but each one of them, I hold a special memory. I look up to in a different way for each one of them. And Stacey, one day, if Stacey told you to do something, you better do it, right? So one day I came home to visit. They would come all the time. I would never come in a woman. Because I didn't love them, I just was in a space. And Stacey took me to a cemetery, didn't ask me if I wanted to go. He was like, get in the car. We went to the cemetery to see my dad, and I think he just saw something. This was before he even expressed interest in the ministry or the name, the minister, any of it. This was years ago. So that spirit was in him a long time ago. And he just started reaching out to me, even when I didn't respond. He just kept reaching out, He would send me pictures of my dad. I have aunts and uncles that would send me pictures of him and share fun stories about him. But when Stacey shared one particular story with me, he healed me and he saved me, because I know there's women out here that can relate. When a father leaves, whether he chooses to leave, he's not there, or he's killed, or for whatever reason, it rips a hole in your soul and it destroys a part of you. And no matter what, as black women, we just keep going. And everybody just think we're all right. And I put on that facade. I was all right. And I wasn't. And Stacey saw that. That's why this ministry was made for him, because he saw that. And so he told me a story one day that I needed to hear and didn't know I needed to hear. He said, you know, the reason I wanted to become a dad was because of your dad. When you were a baby, I used to watch him on Mama Vita's porch, holding you and playing with you. And the way he looked at you, Malika, he loved you so much. And he would turn to jello. And for those who know Mike Gardner, he was like 6'3", mean, like... People were afraid of him, right? And Stace would be like, you know, we would tease him and say, oh, you big, mean, you know, but you with your daughter, you just turned to jello. And that did something for my self-esteem, because I had not at the time. I didn't know my self-worth. I didn't know my self-value, because my father was was missing, and it was through Stacey, who I call the messenger before any of this. He was the messenger from God that I needed to talk to and hear from. And that story set me on a path to do better things and to feel better about myself. That's who Stacey Gardner was for me, and I know he's that way with a lot of other people. He was amazing. He was beautiful. He would not let me go, no matter what. He just held on to me. And so I thank you, Stacey. I thank you so much. You're a beautiful spirit. And your fire, I'm gonna miss you. And when we were kids, it was Stacey that introduced me to Cry the Lonely. With mustard. Scrambled eggs with ketchup. And to this day, I still eat scrambled eggs with ketchup. And I gross everybody out at the table, but I think of my Uncle Stacey. Me and Stacey eat ketchup all right. So I'm gonna miss you, Stacey. I'm gonna miss those encouraging words and your fire and your love. And you were definitely a messenger from God, an amazing human being.
Here. My first thought when I came up, for those that don't know well, I'll say that Stacey's my brother-in-law. But for those who don't know, I was sitting here thinking, how could I follow behind these ministers like this? What can I say differently? What can I say better? And they've said it all. Also sit here and thought, why Stacey? Why this man of God was taken from us? Then I also thought to say, why not? I don't have all the answers for that, so I'm still a work in progress. But I would say they took a good one from us, and he will be missed. Also, I'm sitting there thinking, I've got a lot of things to say, but once I sit down, I wish I'd have said this, I wish I'd have said that. So, I may have time to say something to others after service, but Lela, I offer my condolences. You know, we don't touch base with each other as much as we should as a family. But the thoughts are always there. My prayers are always there with my family members. And I want you to know that. If I don't see you, if I don't converse with you, talk with you, my prayers are always with you. Give one thought. Go back a long time ago with Stacey. And Lance, for those who don't know, I used to play basketball. I broke SIU's scoring record. After my junior year, they gave me a basketball for that. I thought enough of Stacey and Lance. I gave them the basketball, something that, you know, you would treasure as memorabilia for the rest of your life. I thought they would take care of the basketball for me. Next time I came home, they went to Lincoln School, played basketball. My basketball turned brown. I don't know where it is today, but that's how much I thought of these guys for something that meant that much to me. And I thought they would appreciate it. Stacey will be missed. I don't have any other words other than that. I do have one suggestion, and I would encourage all of you that haven't been vaccinated to do so.
Thank you. Thank you.